This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome to our new video series about trigonometry in Math 172. And today I want to talk to you about the unit circle, what we can use it for, and how it's going to be good for us in trigonometry. Let's have a look at it. So, what is the unit circle? The unit circle is simply a circle that is centered on the origin. That is 0, 0, this location here. It has a radius of exactly 1. This means that this point on the right is going to be exactly 1, 0. And every point along this arc is going to be exactly 1 away from the origin. So that this point on the top is going to be 0, 1. This point on the left is going to be negative 1, 0. And this point at the bottom is going to be 0, negative 1. And every point on the circle is exactly 1 away from the center. What's a little bit different about the unit circle is we tend to label the unit circle with angles. The way we label the angles is this way. This point on the right, exactly at 1, 0, is usually labeled with 0 degrees. It's a little counterintuitive. You might expect 0 degrees to be at the top, but in trigonometry, it's on the right. We can see that 0, 1 is exactly a right angle away from 0, meaning we label this with 90 degrees. We could continue and say that on the left we have 180 degrees, just 90 more, and we could add another 90 to reach 270. If we added another 90, we could say that this is also, on the right, 360 degrees, so that 360 degrees and 0 take you to exactly the same place, pretty much what you would expect. But the unique thing about the unit circle is that every angle has an x and y position that goes with it. The way we use this in trigonometry is oftentimes you will be given an angle of some kind, and you'll be asked to return as your answer some sort of x and y position. So if they gave you 90 degrees, you would say the position is 0, 1. If they gave you 270 degrees, you could say your position is 0, negative 1. Now, certain other angles tend to come up fairly often in trigonometry, and I want to talk about those now, not later. For example, what if we went halfway between 0 and 90? We would be on this line right here, halfway between. Well, halfway between 0 and 90 is 45 degrees. It turns out the position at 45 degrees is square root 2 over 2, comma, square root 2 over 2. Now, you may think that looks kind of strange, but we can use the Pythagorean Theorem and we can show that this is actually exactly 1 way from the origin. If you recall, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Well, a and b are both square root 2 over 2. What happens if we raise both of those to the second power? Well, square root of 2 to the second power is just 2. 2 to the second power is 4. For the same reason, b squared is again root 2 over 2 squared gives 2 over 4. If we add these straight across, we get 4 over 4. That's just 1. Therefore, c squared is equal to 1, and c equals 1. And therefore, this point, root 2 over 2, comma root 2 over 2, is still exactly 1 away from the origin. Some other numbers that tend to come up fairly often are 60 degrees here and 30 degrees over here. At 60 degrees, our position is going to be 1/2, comma, root 3 over 2. At 30 degrees, our position will be root 3 over 2, comma, 1/2. They're simply mirror images of each other. Now, there are other angles within the rest of the circle that tend to come up fairly often as well. In next episode, I'll show you how to get the values for those. They're very similar to the values we already have, but we'll talk about that next episode. Thanks for watching.